Rebecca Cottrell, and today I'm here with MP Paul Bonfield to discuss higher education. Hi Paul, so tell us, why is higher education important?
I think it's important for individuals, above all, because it's a life-transforming opportunity, and I think one of the great things the Labour government did was expand the opportunities for higher education. So we're pretty close to 50% participation for 18-year-olds, and that's tremendous. But it's also important because it makes a huge contribution to the local economy, all around the country, and to the national economy, because we need to have people with the right skills, and we need to be at the cutting edge of research and innovation.
And could you explain the fee structure as it stands at the moment?
Well, I can, and it's something I'm not very happy with, because this government introduced, despite the pledges made by one of the coalition partners, the Liberal Democrats, notoriously, they've introduced £9,000 fees for undergraduates, which I think burdens students with an unbelievable level of debt, because the debt isn't only paying the fees, £27,000 when they finish most courses, it's also for all the maintenance costs. So people are coming out with £45,000 of debt, and that's a big burden to start a lifetime's career with.
And what was Labour's policy on fees?
Well, Labour's policy on fees was to see the outcome of the Brown Review. That's what we said at last general election. My own view is that we should be moving to a much fairer system of student contribution. I accept the need for student contribution because students benefit from higher education, society benefits, industry benefits, and we need to get the balance right between those three. But the student contributions need to be done fairly.
Yeah, and obviously Ed Miliband's going about capping it at 6,000. Do you think this is still quite expensive?
I do, and what Ed said was that at the point that the new system was introduced, we wouldn't have done that. At that point, we would have capped fees at 6,000, which I think is important for two reasons. Firstly, it is more affordable, but also it makes sure there's not a market in higher education, because one of the things that this government are trying to do is to create competition between institutions and bring in private providers to create competition based on fee levels, which I think is driving a race to the bottom in terms of quality.
What sort of alternatives do you think you could provide?
Well, my view, and one that hasn't been on the table, is the system of graduate tests. What it means is that instead of people having to make a contribution based on what they need to borrow to get to university, they'll make a contribution after they graduate, depending on what job they get and what their earnings are. And so it breaks the link between fees, which will disappear, and payback. So the people who go on to the big jobs in the City of London will pay back significantly more than the cost of education. But if you go on into a less well-paid job, perhaps in the public sector, perhaps teaching, social work, whatever, then you won't pay back so much. And that seems to be fair, and it would mean that fees wouldn't be a barrier to higher education.